Five. You're on. So I figure that's a good segue. We're adults running a show. We have a band called Like Adults, and in my hand is the CD that would be there had we remembered to tell them to bring a CD. So we're being really good adults right now. Roll the intro. It is cool. Everybody,
how's it going?
Wave to the beautiful people. Act like you can see them. What would you say to them if they were there right now?
Sorry. No.
What did you say?
Sorry, dude. Have you ever seen that, sir? Okay, maybe it's just too old now. I don't know.
I feel like I might be too old for it. What is it?
It's not even relevant.
It's not even relevant? Okay, all right, that's fine. Well, welcome! I'm sitting here with two of the members of Like Adults. So introduce yourselves. Tell us what you play and your name and the name of your first pet.
Okay, my name is Aaron. I play the drums, and my first pet was probably a bird I found in a box.
Did you name the bird? Wait, you found it in the box?
Yeah, it was in a box. I don't know. I found it outside.
Somebody just put a bird in a box, and then you were like, this is my pet now.
And I took it.
Did you steal somebody's bird? Is that what it was?
Yeah, maybe. I don't know, dude. I only had it for like 3 days.
What happened?
Did the bird die? Or?
Oh, I don't even know. My mom like got rid of it. I don't know how she got rid of it.
She took it to the bird farm in the sky.
I don't know. Yeah,
ran away.
Well, did you have a name? Did you have a name for the pet?
I think.
Bird.
No, I don't even think I gave it a name. Honestly, I think I was like, hey, I got a bird. Like, that's what I pretty much told everyone.
Okay, so we'll go with the name Bird in a Box.
Okay,
a box. I think that works. So Aaron drums, Bird in a Box.
Tight. Then I'm Austin, I play guitar and I sing, and my first pet was either a dog or a cat, I don't remember, honestly.
You guys don't remember your first pets?
Well,
did
like,
you have them like way young or
well,
something?
Well, like they were there before us.
Oh, so it's kinda see. They were your parents' pre-kids?
Right, pretty much. So.
The things they were practicing on for us.
Yeah,
yes, they were trying to be like adults. I like your guys. Thank you, Scott. Scott was there. Perhaps the people watching right now enjoyed that as well, but Scott is my only feedback. Usually, sometimes we have a bit of a studio audience here, but just today we have to pretend like people are enjoying our jokes.
It's okay, we have them.
Yeah, but we got Scott, so yeah, that's the important thing. So bird in a box and dog or cat?
Dog or cat, yeah.
Okay. Well, I'm glad I asked that question. That was good. And then you have a third member.
Right.
Who isn't here right now. Did you want to...
Oh, yeah. He's one of my buddies, Brock. You can find him on Instagram. His name is Grandmaster World Destroyer.
And...
best name.
Does he actually destroy worlds?
I just know he's a Grandmaster, but I don't think he destroys worlds.
Do you know what his first pet was? Can you guess what would his first pet be?
He looks like a hamster guy.
Dude, he looks like he would just grow.
He looks like a hamster guy?
Yeah.
He looks like he was just a farmer.
Like an ant farm?
No, like a plant grower.
I see where this is going. I see. You're talking about ferns, aren't you?
Yes.
Those crazy ferns. Those illegal ferns. So welcome to the show. So we are going to be playing some Carmageddon.
Right.
And now you played a little bit of Carmageddon before.
Wasn't
but you'd never heard of Carmageddon. You've never heard of the legend of Carmageddon.
Nah.
Because it's kind of one of those things where like, so Duke Nukem came out and then like Duke Nukem 3D came out and it was a great game in the late 90s. And then there was a huge space in between where they were developing Duke Nukem Forever and it like fell apart and then it finally came out and a bunch of people didn't like it, but really, if you were a fan of like that stupid humor, it was great. And so it's really like the same story with Carmageddon, because there was like a 10 or 12 year lapse in between Carmageddon 2 and like 3 kind of came out. But then I'm just hit start. We could probably talk more because it does take forever to load. Yeah, so if you want to choose your car, we might have more than one car. We did just download it last night. So yeah, hit on tour now there, select. And if you go to the right, so you could be the lady, which is really just a different color.
Go for it.
Or you have this one. Yeah, and then we don't have it. We have an unlocked.
Go to lady.
Yeah, on the PC version of it that I've been playing, I have most of them unlocked. But at this point, that's really useless information that doesn't really help us.
Is the game moddable? Is the game moddable?
I would assume so. I mean, there's a lot of stuff that you can mess around with it already.
Garage.
But no, that's not really right. Really any... So, yeah. Maybe, yeah.
Oh, sorry. I have to stay on this one.
Get in.
What is happening?
Yeah, and then hit B.
Oh, yeah, it's
B.
Garage.
Okay.
And now...
Start.
There you go. Got it. I think you could have been in the other one, but really it's just color.
Okay.
So I put you on an island in this one.
Oh,
so,
SeaWorld.
So have fun. Yeah, it's like Radioactive SeaWorld is kind of what it is. You guys ever been to Radioactive SeaWorld?
No, not yet.
No, not yet? Is that like if San Onofre explodes, even though it's deactivated at this point, it'll make Radioactive SeaWorld?
That'd be pretty tight.
For those of you who don't know, I'm going to tell another boring story about San Onofre. I'm not going to do that, Scott.
I'm not going to do that.
Why you want me to tell a boring story about a now defunct power station in Southern California?
Yeah, I will sit here bored. I'll be like, no.
All right, cool. See, good. Somebody has to stop me. All right, here we go.
All right. Okay, let's see if I remember even half.
So yeah, for those of you watching at home, if you've ever seen Carmageddon,
What are you doing? Get out of here.
Well done. Well played. Well played. Okay. Good prank. You can do one of three things. You could race the race and go through all the checkpoints, which is the most boring. Nice! You already killed him.
Oh shit, I'm getting on the water. No, I'm not gonna go on
the water. Sweet little jump. Woo! Nice. Or you could run over all of the pedestrians, which there are only 200 in this one, so you could actually do that. Some of them are actually pretty hard to find. Or you could just destroy all the other cars, which is the way that I like to go.
Like this guy. Oh. All right. Oh shit.
Yeah, he's like Cold War era.
Dude, this place is messed.
Awesome, you know.
Already messed up.
There you go. If you do ever fall in water again, there's an underwater driving ability that's just like a power up that you pick up.
Oh, there is.
Okay. Yeah, and those cops suck, by the way. They're like super invincible, and they will chase you forever. So that's just your buddy now. Your buddy cop.
Oh, there he
say.
Is. I found him. Hold on. I gotta get around.
Ballet bonus.
Alright.
What's that guy doing? He's not even moving.
Just hanging out, you know. Doing his thing.
Turn around. Oh, that's not what I wanted to do. Okay.
Can you change the difficulty?
It's already really hard.
Some people are calling you a bird stealer. From earlier. You are now known as the bird thief.
Forgot, what kind of bird was it? Was it a hummingbird?
It was a hummingbird.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh! There's a little baby hummingbird, like in a box.
Dude, what the hell's going on with this right here? This is like...
They're just having a little party right now,
I guess.
They're partying down. You could explore the island a little bit, see what's going on in Radioactive SeaWorld.
Awesome.
Oh, now you're joining. Yeah, you'll just join it too.
Alright, I'm just gonna get around this wheel.
Yeah. So since we're watching this car game.
Oh, thanks, bro.
he helped you out. You guys have cars, right?
Yeah.
What do you drive?
Sorry.
Oh, I drive a Ford Fusion.
Ford Fusion. Dang.
It was our Nana's.
Yeah, she gave it to me. She's like too old to drive. So she just gave it to me.
Nice.
Yeah.
What about you?
I drive a 2000 Toyota Camry, which finally passed smog.
Yeah! Congratulations!
It took me over a year.
Did you go to Sizzler afterwards? Celebrate?
I should have. That would have been pretty cool.
Hometown buffet.
Hometown buffet. No, that's where you should go with your grandma's car.
No, that's where you go.
That's where I'll go.
No, that's where you go if you want to get the shits after drinking the chocolate milk. Okay, what's going on right now?
I think, really, just eating or drinking anything there is probably a poor decision.
Obviously,
we're not sponsored by Hometown Buffet.
Darn.
What were you saying? You what?
They had cockroaches.
Yeah, also a bad reason to go there. Or a good reason to not go there, depending on which side you're on.
Nah, but what happened? My car went past Mog for over a year, and finally it did. And then, of course, the day after I get my car all registered and whatnot, I get a citation.
Oh, great.
And
for what?
Because I didn't have my sticker, even though it was already registered.
Oh, but you just told him, right?
No. Well, no. And
oh, you just got split in pieces.
Dicked.
Try to drive.
Oh!
Okay.
I got really surprised by the other half of your car coming back at you. Spazzed. You're all flattened out. And way... You've been wrecked. So, yeah. Luckily, in free play mode, you're pretty much invincible.
All right, cool. Okay. I'm missing a couple tires.
Somebody asked, would you rather have to punch a car that's driving towards you very fast or a flaming bear?
Whatever kills me faster.
Because you're gonna die either way, I guess.
I'd say the
bear. Might be the car. Really?
I'd say the bear.
I feel like getting mauled by a bear.
Because you're kind of just sitting there taking it from the bear. But like, you just get hit by a car.
That's it. You're done.
You're
toast.
You're done, dude.
Right. Yeah. That's if we're talking.
Okay, what is going on?
That's a good question.
Yeah.
That's
just
like a
mine. Just hit X.
Okay.
There you go. Yeah. Get the hell out of there. Yeah, I think I'd go with the car, just because it seems awful to be mauled by a flaming bear.
The bear would be kind of funny. Like, oh, how did you die?
Yeah, for
flaming
who?
Bear.
Yeah, who would you tell? Oh,
yeah, who are you telling?
Bear? How?
Dude,
is this an afterlife situation? Because then we could really
you're
speculate with things.
In, like the chair in like the office, you're just like, how'd you get here? Let me tell you,
yeah, flaming bears.
Boy. Or if it's like Beetlejuice, everybody is kind of
weird
in
yeah.
their like how they died already.
Just,
and
like,
so you just be
like
this. Yeah, in pieces, like kind of scorched with bear bites.
Gotcha.
Nice. With bear bites. That sounds like the new treat at Burger King.
Bear is it bites. True that Burger
like
King's
like,
leaving California?
Like cookies or whatever.
I heard that Burger King's leaving California.
Really?
Yeah, what? That's what I heard. I was really bummed out when somebody told me that. I was like, oh, dude, those croissant wish. Croissant wish are pretty good.
The most American way of saying the most American screwed up word.
The croissant wish.
The croissant wish.
It's like quesadilla.
Right, or quesadilla. Take it one step further. Further.
Alright, did I just get that guy?
No, I didn't get it. That's one pointy car.
Okay, dude, I'm totally fucking up right now. Everybody who's watching this, I'm really sorry.
It's all good. I mean, you're just driving around running into things, which
no,
is really the idea of the game.
Jabbing me in the ass, that's what this guy's doing.
Really
sweet. Oh, that's pretty funny.
Ooh, somebody's got a strategy for the whole flaming bear situation. If you can avoid the bear for a few minutes, it will eventually burn to death.
There you go, bear.
Oh, that's true,
so
that's true.
If you can get away from the flaming bear... That's not a bad idea.
Or
but
if you save the bear's life, you might have a new pet. That would be pretty tight.
Or he's already summoned the pet.
That's like it's that simple to save a bear. You don't think that it would just be extremely pissed off and be confused as to why it was on fire?
Well, did you light it on fire? Or
does it know? Like, does it understand what fire is?
Bears are
or does it think,
smart.
I'm in a ridiculous amount of pain and you're closest to me. Surely you must have done that. Speaking of flames. You got it. You can do it. One of these
times.
I'm
going to make it happen. I'm going to make it happen.
Well, you're just going further and further into debt. It's like you went to college.
All right.
Are you going to college? Are you doing that?
I got to take one more class and then I can get my AA.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, then that's it.
I'm in high school.
You know, it's just
do you have college plans?
Yeah.
Where are you going to go?
Never go.
that's your plan.
That's his plans.
Community
yeah.
college?
Yeah, UCLA. Left on Avery.
Oh,
Saddleback.
Nice. Oh!
Okay, I'm in huge debt. Let's just
yeah,
keep it
it's
going.
Just... See, it's like... It's a great talk about college because just put yourself further into debt. And who knows if it'll help. In this situation, you get a badass car, but college does not guarantee a badass
car. You're going to be that guy that actually runs out of time.
It could happen. Yeah, I'm actually still driving my first car from high school.
What kind?
It's a Volvo 240 station wagon.
There you
1992.
Go.
1992. Yeah, when I first got it, it was the most uncool car in the world. And now, everybody loves it. And I can fit a 10-foot surfboard inside, so that's nice. Good.
All right, here we go. Wrong checkpoint. Oh, no, that didn't do anything.
I want to get like a mom van. Like a little
van?
Like a soccer mom van.
Uh-huh.
I want to get one of those. This is a cool one.
One of my friends in college, his mom was actually on The Price is Right. And
oh,
she...
Oh, our mom.
Oh, really?
Yeah, yeah, that was weird.
She won a mirror.
Oh,
and a
well,
fire.
His mom won like the showcase showdown and a new car was in it. But she didn't need a new car, so she just gave it to him. But it was like a minivan. So he had like this brand new sweet minivan. And like you don't see college kids driving around. Like maybe like a broke ass old minivan or something.
Yeah.
But not
like,
a brand,
new.
Like ready to pick up your kids from soccer. There's nothing else you can do.
That, it's like, get in.
This is
right.
Are you sure?
Yeah. Yeah. At that point, it's like his dorm room.
One of our buds used to have a van, and I guess one of his friends started fucking his girlfriend in the backseat.
Wow.
He wasn't pretty cool about that.
Wait, while he was driving?
Yeah, he was driving, I guess, and a couple of his friends just started, you know, going to town.
Yeah, that sucks. That seems rude. That seems pretty rude.
Like, oh, hey, thanks for driving, bro. And then,
just
don't mind me.
Keep it moving. Thanks for the hotel room. Are they still friends, or did that not really work out?
That's about as far as he told of the story. So I don't know. Maybe he is still friends with them.
Hmm.
I mean, I can't imagine that would be, like, what, you know, breaks it up.
Well, I mean, I guess it depends on who they were, like, you know, was
maybe
he interested in this girl or whatever?
That
do could
you
be.
Know?
What?
Do you know?
I don't know.
You bored over there?
No, I just, he, like, asked me if I did, like, I had no idea he was talking about it at all.
Oh, they weren't mutual friends?
I don't know.
Don't you remember Chris telling us that? Yeah, because Chris used to have a mom van or whatever. What's up, Chris?
Hopefully it didn't become a mom van again for the girl.
Right?
That would be unfortunate.
That would have sucked.
Yeah.
Too many friends are doing that shit.
Too many friends are doing that shit? Yeah, my son is due in a couple weeks. But I'm also 28 years old and married, so it makes sense.
There you go. What is it? Our brother just had a kid, too.
Yeah.
She is now 7 months old, right?
Is she?
Yeah, 7 or 6 months old.
No, I think she's 8.
I mean, that's a month.
It's
difference.
A month.
Sorry. What does that matter? Still an infant that can't really do anything or take care of themselves.
She's like adult.
She's like adult.
She's like adult. Not plural. Boy, you are in debt.
You are, this is not happening.
Yeah, you are in debt big time.
All right. Man, I did so much better when no one was watching.
That's the way it goes, man. That's the way it goes.
All right, let's do this thing again. I bet you I can do it now. Nope. 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 Lots of nopes.
Would you rather get into a fight with Link, Mario, or Cloud?
Probably Mario.
No, because Mario can burn your ass.
Okay, well, Link can shoot you with a bow, hit you with a boomerang, freaking blow you away with a leaf. Like,
that's true. He's got
I like how that last one seems a lot less awful than like getting shot with a bow or hit with a boomerang or blow you away with a leaf.
But it's like, okay.
I mean, I know what you're talking about, but just like if somebody doesn't, I mean, everybody knows.
Yeah.
But if somebody doesn't know that, I'd
they're
be like,
what?
Why the hell is that? Doesn't seem, take the leaf, go with the leaf guy. Go with the leaf guy and then, like, hit him and you should be okay.
And then Cloud's, like, he's got his huge sword.
Yeah,
like,
yeah, I'd stay away from Cloud for sure. But I feel like you might be able to, like, make him cry or something. You could probably reach his emotions pretty
quickly.
Or pull his hair. Yeah, that would actually be a good one. Yeah, Mario will just jump on you. I feel like Mario might be the most dangerous.
You do that down punch thing.
Right.
Where he'll spin you.
Yeah, that's... That would be no good.
Okay, but the thing is, Link has more thing. Like, he has more...
He does, yes. He's a very... He could kill you in many different ways.
Okay, dude, this guy's really pissing me off.
Like, Mario...
Yeah, he's been hunting you this entire game.
Oh, man. I've only killed two guys. Okay,
Austin, look how much you're in debt. Oh, my God.
I know, shut up.
The best part is, it doesn't matter. But if you get into debt in real life, it does matter. Don't do that. Don't get into debt. Entour Now doesn't support anything we say. Except that one. Don't get into debt. That's just a common sense one. You guys in debt?
I mean...
Not yet.
To your parents, probably.
I might.
A few million dollars.
Right?
Oh God, what have I done? I don't have millions of dollars. You guys have millions of dollars?
I wish.
No.
What would you do if somebody gifted you, like, a great-great aunt that you never knew lived in a different country gifted you $1 million? Sounds like an internet scam, but it actually worked. What's the first thing you would do?
Congratulations, you won right there. Probably buy a bird or something.
A bird?
Like, I'd buy one.
I thought you said burger for a second, then I remember you said bird.
I mean, both of which are equally kind of ridiculous if you have $1 million.
Well, it's like, if you have $1 million, someone's gonna be like, oh, what's the first thing you bought, bird? Just flat out right there.
Taking it back to when you were a kid.
I'd probably get new gear. Like a new guitar.
Yeah, that makes sense. What would you buy? What's your dream guitar?
One that works. No,
I mean, that's good. That's good. Dream big.
Starcaster.
Yeah, Starcaster. First act. Let's see how much debt I can get.
The Starcaster isn't even a squire. That's how unfortunate it is.
Probably like a Fender Tele, but single bridge pickup. That's it.
So pretty basic. An Esquire? Isn't that what that is?
Is that what that is?
A Tele with just the bridge pickup?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, then that. Give me that.
Yeah, it was originally called the Broadcaster, but then that was like taken. So then it was called the Esquire. That's like Paul McCartney... In his solo career after the Beatles, he used the Esquire a lot.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, those are cool guitars. Still... Oh, did you get an achievement?
Did I?
You'll take someone's eye out with...
Parts or collateral. And
suck my parts is what you also got.
Okay, where's the third guy? I keep seeing these two same guys.
Oh, he's right over there. To the right.
To the right?
He's the one who was hunting you. Right. Good, oh, almost a good position.
How does it feel? Okay.
So, out of curiosity, after the bird, what would you buy?
Okay. probably new gear or something. I don't know.
Okay. Do you have, like, a dream set that you would?
I have no idea. Honestly, I'd probably just look around for anything custom, really.
Yeah.
What else?
Or invest it.
Stocks.
You've been talking about stocks a lot recently.
That's the smart way to go. But not the fun way to go. You should just buy a bunch of birds. And
make my own bird farm, bro.
And then for like 5 or 6 years, you'll be living. You'll be living on the edge of
birds. What do you do? I breed birds.
What kind of birds? Yeah. Just birds.
Any type.
Any kind.
Chickens.
I have 4,000 pigeons. Aren't those kind of free? I feel like that would be that's the free bird.
If you can catch it, it's yours.
Yeah, really. I call them sky rats.
Ew.
That's pretty much what they are.
That was pretty cool.
They're just
kinda...
dirty birds.
And not one of them is like normal looking. Like there's always something.
They've always got pieces missing.
Yeah.
All of them. All of them. They are not complete in box.
Like if something's not missing, there's something hanging. Like there's something different.
I like that you made your own sound effects.
Come on, can this guy just blow up? Right?
I mean, he's like a monster truck. It's gonna be a different
one. Yeah, I'm like a Corvette with spikes.
The Mohawk.
Razor.
What are those spikes even for? Like, in case someone goes on top of you or something?
Yeah, I think so. Oh, nice. You, like, kind of knocked him out. I think there might be mines in the water. Maybe he'll just drive into them and he'll solve the problem himself. Oh, he respawned. And so did you. Oh, sorry, and there goes that dog.
Dog meat.
Dog meat, just like Fallout.
Hey, that's probably where they got that from.
Somebody said that they would buy a million mochis.
Mochis? Those are free. Wrong.
Oh, no. Mochi, the little...
Is that ice cream?
Yeah, like the little Japanese ice cream. Also a very solid investment.
It's so sad. I'm so obsessed
until
with it.
Until they all go like bad after a week.
Right, yeah. I mean, I guess you can freeze them, but really logistics doesn't matter if you're talking about buying a million mochi.
Then you have to buy all the fridges. Come on.
Fridges? Oh, yeah, keep them in. Just get a big cooler.
What'd you buy? A million fridges. One mochi per. How would you pay for the electricity in that situation?
Doesn't matter.
You have $1 million.
I feel like this may be the never-ending game.
Straight up, dude. This is going to take forever.
You've been at 2 minutes for like the past 10 minutes.
Yeah, see, the problem is every time you hit somebody, you get 10 more seconds, and that guy's not going to die ever.
No.
And you're 31,000 credits in debt.
Let me just push him off. And this guy comes around and just... Fuck.
You just need to be like adult. Take care of it. Yeah, this might... We might have to...
That's totally cool.
We might have to do an intervention here.
I already know what you're going to say. Sorry, bro.
It's all good.
No, I was talking to the guy I just killed. Oh, okay. Oh, okay. And boom, that didn't do anything.
Oh, cool. You
just all right, give us a big final stunt to end on. How about that? Right. Find a jump and...
All right, let's do this.
There it was.
And... Oh, that guy's still on fire.
Epic enough.
In the water.
Oh, so it's safe.
Back to the sea, from where you came! There you go.
And now, part-time submarine.
20,000 leagues.
Is that a bomb?
The sea. There you
there,
go.
Yeah.
That's a good... Okay, cool. great. Let's do an interview now, shall we? what did we definitely not already talk about, but... we were talking about you guys. You started playing together like 6 years ago.
Yeah.
And so what brought you to, I guess, your style? Who are your influences?
What was it? Well, even before that, in like 2004, because I used to just listen to like radio. Wow, what am I going through? Puberty?
You're becoming like an adult.
I'm becoming an adult.
Or just like adult. You're becoming like adult.
That's pretty much it. But what was it? In like... You know, I used to just listen to, like, Radio Disney, just whatever was
Radio Disney,
right?
Hey.
Good days.
I love that we're moving into a generation where people's influences have come from Radio Disney.
Yeah, totally.
That's pretty funny.
Like, Bowling for Soup or what?
No, it was like Kidz Bop, basically.
Right, yeah.
It was a joke. And my best friend, he showed me Green Day, American Idiot.
Nice.
And then after that, I was like, oh my god, what is all this other music? Mm-hmm. And then that's what kind of made everything just open up. That's when I wanted to do like pop punk.
So you were trapped by Radio Disney.
Yeah.
And then
I was
freed by like skate punk.
Right. I was so oblivious to any other kind of music. Like in 2008 or so, that's when I had my huge Blink 182 phase.
Oh, nice.
And then after that, I was like, I'm still figuring out all these songs that like my girlfriend, she'll go, oh, don't you know this song? Like it was huge during that. I'm like, I don't fucking know, dude. Like, I never used to listen to music
until now. See, that's the most fun part about music is there's so much of it, you can just continue to discover music forever.
Oh, yeah.
Like, even people like Scott, for example, he's heard billions of years of music at this point. But there's still plenty of fresh stuff, and there's still plenty of old stuff that he has never heard. And that's just, like, that's the beauty of music.
Yeah.
It's just like thinking of how many TV shows are on Netflix.
Oh, yeah.
You're never going to be able to watch all of that.
Nah.
And there's even more music.
I'm super thankful for Bob's Burger on Netflix.
Bob's Burger, yeah, that's good.
That's a great show. Yeah. You need to watch it.
That's a catchy intro song there, too.
Put it on a mixtape.
You
for my girlfriend for her birthday.
You did?
I put the theme song on a mixtape.
On a tape or a CD?
Well, like a CD, you know.
A mix CD.
A mix CD. Mm,
yeah. Okay. So, and you guys, you don't have any live shows coming up, but you've obviously played live shows in the past. How's, like, the energy with that? Because I know a lot of bands have a lot of difficulty, especially with, like, the younger generation, to engage people to, like, be into the music, as opposed to just kind of, you know, being on your phone or just standing there and just watching you blankly. Do you find that you can get that energy in people?
It kind of depends on the show.
I mean,
I've got kind of, like, two modes where either, you know, the crowd, it's super late or it's super tired, so I'm just kind of like,
screw it.
I'm kind of like, fuck it, I'm tired too, like, just be sarcastic and,
Okay.
Like, oh, hey, this next song is about, like, we got this one song called Afraid to Die off of our first LP. And I'll be like, okay, who's sad? And, you know, like, that's it. And then
That's a great question. Who's sad?
Yeah,
or like,
yeah,
and just starts the song or whatever. Like, I'll just be like, hey, who likes fat dick? And I'll go right into it. And then there's like,
What's the song on the LP that's like, it's very much kind of like bubblegum pop?
That's like all of them.
Well, but it's like there's one very specific where it's like that 50s kind of chord progression. It's like right in the middle of the album.
Board of Us? Or
I think that's it.
Where it's the acoustic like, one.
No, it isn't acoustic.
No. Okay.
It's got like backing vocals in it.
There's only eight of them. It's got to be one of them.
It's one. Well, one of those songs.
It's probably Like Adults. That's like the most 50s sounding one on there.
I think so.
Oh, and in case you guys didn't know. Songs.
Well, no, because Like Adults is the second song.
No, it's a couple more in than that.
Hand Me Down?
If I was a better host, I would have known the name of that song.
Not that. That's not 50s.
Well, anyways, it's definitely got the vibe that a lot of people are going for today with like Burger Records or Lollipop or something.
Yeah.
Okay.
Where it's kind of like that. Where you take that bubblegum stuff and then put the garage attitude in. And how's your recording process? Did you like actually go to a studio and all that? Or did you do home stuff?
I don't stand a chance. We went to Nick Mack at Hi-Fi Critter. He's in Riverside.
Okay, okay.
I mean, he's always been there.
Sunny Riverside, the vacation capital of California.
Right. You know what's funny, though? Every time we go there to record, it's always raining.
Really?
It's super weird. And wow. It's like the hottest place to go to.
Yes.
Every time we go,
yeah,
it's always raining.
The hottest place to go to.
Yeah, seriously.
Definitely not the hottest place to go to.
No, it's kind of industrial. But... Yeah.
It's okay. If you live in Riverside, we love it. Let's leave it at that.
But the EP I recorded in my bedroom.
So oh, you did?
Yeah.
Okay.
That was pretty fun.
Nothing wrong with that.
Nah,
cool. No, we recorded it in the garage.
Well, yeah, but everything else was in... It's DIY. You
right.
Know?
A like home, bedroom home recording.
Yeah.
Well, and that's the nice thing. You can do that now.
Yeah.
You have the ability to do that. It used to be a lot more difficult, but now you can just... If you have a junky computer and a crappy mic, go for it.
Yeah, I can't emphasize
that's what we do here.
I think Scott needs a little webcam for him.
It would be funny.
Just like one like right in front, just like awkward.
Well, see, at one point that was kind of an idea that we had because we had another guy who still works on the show, but he ended up moving up to Oregon, and he was going to be like the director of the show. And every once in a while, it was going to cut to him on like a spaceship. It was a really cool, like stupid, weird, crazy idea. But then it just never happened, and we just have Scott.
Scott,
you guys are the only ones who have the joys of seeing Scott sitting there. I think this is the single episode where we've mentioned Scott the most.
Really?
Yeah. We could label this one the Scott episode.
He's so crucial.
Like Adults on the Scottisode. He is very crucial. Because if he wasn't here, it would be just me sitting on a couch talking to you guys. And then be like, all right, well, thanks for coming.
With like no effects on the camera. It's just like, just us. That's
yeah,
it.
Yeah. No camera, no mics. We just have a conversation, play a game, and then See you later. What was the inspiration for the name Like Adults? Because I think it's really cool. I dig it.
Do you want to take the reins on this one?
I don't even know. I think it was just... I think we just came up with it because we were just trying to figure it out for like a month or two. And we were just like, man, we should probably figure out a name or something.
Always a good idea.
And then we just looked at the track listing on I Don't Stand a Chance. We're like Adult sounds pretty good. And that's pretty much it. I mean, I don't know if there's any other reason for you.
Well, we used to be called Anorak, which is our last name, Caruana, spelled backwards.
Okay.
But, you know, anytime we'd play live or try to, you know, promote or be like,
wait, are you brothers?
Yeah.
Oh, shit. I feel like that should have come up by now.
That's why I'm trying to remember the bird story. I'm like, when the fuck did that happen?
Okay. All right. But you also don't remember the cat or the dog?
No.
Okay. No. Not a very good pet memory. We had another band called Pet Clinic on here. I don't know why I brought that up. We had a band named Pet Clinic. Isn't that interesting?
What was their first pet?
Let me give him a call real quick. You guys just want to sit here, chill out?
No.
I'll call him. Now, the people are asking about Scott. They're like, Scott, come over here. Scott, come sit on the couch. Scoot, show yourself. We should just call you Scoot.
Hey, Scooter.
Scooter, the director. Yeah. Cool.
Yeah. I mean, we've had so many different names, and
That's when you create like a band when you're as young as you guys are. That's the way it goes, because the things you're into change so quickly. Like at this point, I know what I like. I don't know what my band name would be. 131ers. That'll be my band name. That's another band that we had on the show. I'm just going to throw out names of bands that have been on the show.
Who else?
Mostly Kosher. That was last week.
Nice.
I need to look
Real Big
guys.
Fish.
Real Big Fish?
Suburban Legends. Other ska bands. Speaking of ska bands. Oh, actually, you know what? Before we get into the Geometry Wars challenge, I forgot, we have a sketch. So I was telling you guys a little bit before, every week, starting since like the last 4 weeks or so, we've looked at the band name that we're going to be having on the show, and we just came up with some ridiculous sketch.
Right.
And so we looked at Like Adults, and this is what we came up with. Roll it, Scott. Roll it, Scoot! Ah, good evening. My name is Lester Hungrove, and welcome to the first installment of Like Adults. In this thrilling educational experience, we will teach you how to live life to the fullest and answer questions like, should I light myself on fire? Or can I go sleepy now? Certainly questions that have plagued myself. If we Brits could win the Battle of Cambrai in 1917... then surely you can learn how to live to the ripe old age of 53. To drive the point home like a mortar shell piercing through the snowy lines of the Western Front, the talents of Chip and Stu will demonstrate what one should and should not do. Chip is the ideal adult, whilst Stu is not. What have we here? Is it dawn already? Wrong! You fail, Stu! Correct! Waking up early and refreshed is the only way to begin the day like adults. Office work is the jungle gym of adulthood. Let's see how Stu's getting on. Wrong! Come on, Stu! Correct! You must attend to every task, no matter how menial it might seem. Remember, the weakest vessel will doom the entire fleet to a watery grave. And no one likes a puss. Leisure time? Wrong! You're going to die alone, Stu! Correct! A devil's mind is a false idol that toils on the physical embodiments of men. Bill pay, check into cash. You have no money, Stu. Wrong! Wrong!
Correct! Observe the wingspan on that Curtis H.A. Dunkirk fighter. Impressive. Yard! Outside! Manual laborious! Wrong, Stu! Give up, man! Give up, Stu! Give up! Correct! You can take the country out of the country, but you cannot rip the Zeppelin out of the great German air coup of 1996! Well, there you have it. I am Lester Hungrove, and that's how you learn how to live like adults. Now cut the tape, give your friend a tap on the fanny, and it doesn't make sense, but it'll make sense eventually, and you'll ever find out the truth behind the Shrine of the Silver Monkey. Once again, I'm Lester Hungrove. We'll see you next week for our Christiversary special.
So hopefully you guys learned how to live like adults. You learned a lot from that sketch that you could definitely hear, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Words to live by. Words to live by. If you had any advice for your future self when you are a true like adults, what would it be? I'm just going to answer. I want to ask you really stupid, meaningless questions because I feel like everybody in interviews asks like, you know, the regular stuff, but no one asks all the pointless questions that only I care about. This show is for me. I'll watch it later and be like, that was a good question, Greg. That was a good question. All
right, you answer.
Yeah, what's your advice?
No, you answer it first.
Okay. No, you answer no. first.
Okay. It's a good question. Don't get in debt.
Really don't get in debt. That's a good one. That's
don't
a good
light
one.
Any bears on fire.
Don't light any bears on fire. Also a good one. Yeah, those are words to live by right there. Remember that. So 10 years from now, when you're thinking like, what do I do with my life? I'm lost. I'm confused. Wait, I've answered it before. And you can go back and you can watch this episode again. Thanks for the view later on. We appreciate it.
No problem.
10 years from now, when this show... when YouTube doesn't even exist anymore and all that fun stuff. It probably won't. Like, really? It's been around long enough at this point. Everything goes away like that. Well, you know, like, MySpace was the shit for, like, 10 years.
Yeah.
And that is non-existent.
Well, that's like saying it's, like, get rid of TV. Like, it's been around for a while.
But... Google.
Yeah, but that's like cable TV
okay,
is
well,
going
Google's
away.
Okay, like a search engine. Like, you have to use it. Like.
But it's something else could be.
Yahoo.
There.
Binge. Bing. Binge. Bing.
Bing. That's like the croissant-witch.
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 I'm a speech impediment.
Yeah. So, now is the time in the show where you get to show everybody your Geometry Wars prowess. You're not nervous, right?
Oh, I'm so nervous.
Of course you aren't. You'll beat the high score. So, over here you can see... Oh, you're just going for it. He's going for it, ladies and gentlemen. The high score to beat is 1.5 million, still by Hooray for Our Side. I mean, they're cool guys. We had a great time, but they've been on the leaderboard for long enough.
I'm really bad.
Good. Confidence. Confidence is key. You've got it. While he's playing this, if you guys want to send us some more questions, as weird as they may be,
we'll answer them.
Yes. They will answer them. I don't know who's going to answer first, but one of them will answer.
I'm busy asking you answer this.
Yes.
That's fine.
Yes. You are very... You are... It is a very important task.
This game is hypnotic.
It really is. It really is. And somehow this music never gets old. Like, I can't tell you how many times we've played this game, but this music does not get old. It's weird.
On that constant loop.
Yeah. Like, we'll also play Scoot and I. We'll play Virtual Pinball on here, and they have Star Wars ones. And one of them just plays the Cantina theme endlessly. And it's awful. It's awful. I love Star Wars. I love the Cantina theme.
Yeah.
But once you've heard it for like an hour, it is the worst song in the world. It is so annoying.
They only know one song, too.
They, well, two. Two songs.
Two songs. Yeah.
But they sound almost exactly the same. Yeah. Alright, I think you can do it. I have faith.
I know.
How many tries?
Well, if you don't have faith, you gotta have faith.
Well, how many tries does he get? Just this one?
It's just this one try.
Okay.
It's just this one try. You get as many practice tries as you want while we're not live. Which, by the way, I will say, he did get 2.1 million in one of the practice goes. So he is a competent player, but it could be one of those stage... That was good. Good move. It's difficult. It's a lot of pressure. It's a lot of pressure when you have... I think you could do it.
I know.
Come on, dude. Come on.
Don't be cocky.
I'm not. I'm not at all.
That's
the one thing you gotta live by, not be cocky, because you know for a fact.
Somebody asks, what is your favorite 90s band?
American Football.
It's a tough one.
Yeah.
I'll just say Nirvana. They're a classic.
Great, good. My favorite teenage fan club. If you ever heard of them? You are so close to getting this. You are so close, my friend. You got 10 seconds. Oh my gosh, you can. No! You can do it! No! Oh.
Now you're just messing up, dude.
Yeah. That doesn't give you points.
I know.
Such a dildo.
Oh, you were so close!
I'm really good.
That was very
good. Dude, that's
good.
My score, 9 million, right?
That was, yeah, 9.4 million. Congratulations. Unfortunately, that scoot score.
Floppy earlobes?
Yeah, he didn't do so hot. I think he probably only played it a couple times, though. What is your favorite triangle? Because why not?
Acute.
Okay, all right.
Oh,
I'm gonna go obtuse.
Like them big.
Those are
just wonky. What's your favorite? What are you trying to sneak in another one here? You're trying to sneak it in like we didn't notice. You really didn't want to answer the triangle question.
This counts as first try, right?
Yeah, this counts
that
as first
was
try.
That first practice one.
Yep, definitely the definitely.
Nobody was watching.
I mean, technically on this show, we really don't have any rules. You're the first one to actually just go for another round. So I'd say, if you get it, we'll give it to you. Just because Sweet. I think it's really entertaining that you took the initiative and you said, no, screw your rules. I'm going to try again.
Seemed pretty good, too. Look at that.
Keep in mind,
swervy derby over here.
If you don't do it, that's going to be pretty embarrassing. It won't really be very embarrassing at all.
It would be so embarrassing.
All your friends at school are gonna say, dude, I saw you, it was so embarrassing.
Yeah, they're all gonna laugh at you.
You tried it twice. Yeah, the teachers are gonna stop in the middle of the course and be like, I gotta say something.
This guy is just a complete joke. He's pathetic.
Your performance
was so
yesterday
awful.
Yesterday? You have Sunday class? Is that you go to class on Sundays now?
Church.
You,
I had Sunday
guys,
school.
Yeah, Sunday school. I was going to say something about Sunday school, but I guess I probably shouldn't. Go to it. That's my advice.
Everybody needs Jesus.
Everybody needs Jesus. Oh, that's right. You know what? Actually, somebody brings up a good point. Hooray for our side. Technically did have two tries because they were on our show twice. So the first time, I don't think they did very well, but then the second time they definitely did better. So they did, but it was like technically two different shows.
Fair game.
The Bears on fire believe in you.
I gotta get this game.
it's an addictive one. All right, you got it.
You can
do this.
Yeah.
Do your best to not die.
Take it to the end.
Yep. To not die and not use bombs. You got it.
I already used one.
No, but I mean, just don't use
them
now
because
it'll clear the board and you won't get the points. You got this, dude. You got it. It's gonna be close.
Just not enough for spawning.
You got it. Here it is. Here it is. Fly through that thing. Get the bonus. You got. You can do it. You can do it. Keep going. Oh,
jeez. That was so close.
You once again.
I'm very close. I'm sorry. Very
close.
Look at that. That was so
no,
close.
You weren't. You aren't a failure. In all things, in this, yes, you are a failure. But in life, you are not a failure. You're in a band. You have a job. Do you have a job?
I have a job.
You have a job.
You sleep
on a bed.
Yeah.
That's great. That's better than a lot of people. Yeah. Well, I guess maybe that's not cool. a lot of. I don't know. That's good. That's good that you have a bed.
Okay.
This is on tour now with the pertinent life questions about birds in boxes and having beds. So now is when we are going to do our giveaway. So last week we had the band Mostly Kosher, which was like a klezmer band, on. And we have this sweet t-shirt right here, as well as their album. And that is going to Adam Moreno. He is the big time winner. I believe Rex Tano is his internet's name. And then we also did a second giveaway. Can you believe it? We did a second giveaway.
That's two.
That is two.
Wow, Austin, that was good, dude.
You got it.
I count.
See, look up to this guy. Look up to this guy.
Jared Long would be proud.
Jared Long. I still have to listen to his record.
You're not missing out.
It's not good?
I don't know. It's a complete joke.
But does it have something to do with two?
Well, he does like a Day to Remember like parody. It talks about counting. I don't know. It's a stupid song.
Okay. Great. Well, we did a second giveaway. And it's for tickets to the Forever Came Calling show, who we had on our band.
Wow.
this is a band now. We've all created a band. Scott is obviously on the doorbell thing. And you play the bird in the box. You play the cat or dog. And I play the messing up English. And so, we had that band on our show.
Okay.
And so we gave away tickets. There's also As It Is on the bill. At Chain Reaction, July 12th. Peter Salvadori. Congratulations. Round of applause. What did he do to win it? Was he just chosen?
Twitter.
He's Twitter. He's Twitter, and that's how he won the tickets. So if you guys want to win, we do random subscriber, and we ask questions on Twitter. So the best way to win is subscribe here. And follow us on Twitter and look for those questions. And maybe you guys could win stuff, too.
I'm down.
Down.
You're down to win?
Yeah.
D to W?
Yeah.
Yeah, cool. All right, so where can these fine people find you?
You can find us at likeadults.com. We're on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Spotify, iTunes, everywhere.
You're everywhere.
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 Or just go on Bandcamp and type in Like Adults and find us.
Yeah, that too.
And it's great that you have likeadults.com.
Yeah.
That is, when bands have just their name.com, that's the greatest thing in the world. And I also find it hard to believe that Like Adults was not taken.
Yeah, so were we.
Yeah, that's, in this day and age, like everything is...
Pretty much already, yeah.
Yeah, they're all taken. And then so Like Adults, I would assume, but no, you got it. So go to likeadults.com, and you guys don't currently have any shows coming up, but soon.
Very soon.
Soon. And then you can say hi to your new bassist.
Yeah. His name's Brock.
His name's Brock. And what was his Instagram?
Grandmaster World Destroyer.
Grandmaster World Destroyer. Also kind of hard to believe that somebody didn't take that one earlier, too. Like, as weird as it is, I would have assumed that somebody would have taken that.
What is it, like, on, like, Instagram, you can have, like, your name be in your bio, and he just chose Cancer Cell. So you could just type in Cancer Cell, and I'm pretty sure his name will come up, too.
Really?
Yeah, I think so.
Interesting. Yeah, I guess don't type that on Google unless you want to be really sad.
Yeah.
Well, on that note, this has been On Tour Now. And, oh, I have to do something else. Oh, right! These guys just released a new song today, and I'm pointing to the... what is the name of it? I love the name. What is it? I can read it now. So Much For That. I think that's... I love that name.
Oh, thanks.
What inspired that?
Well, from all the stuff that happened, because we had... one of our members decided he's going to, you know, travel to Europe and stuff like that. He wants to be an adventurer and whatnot,
so
we applaud him for that. And then our old bassist, he wants to go back to college. So we lost two guys, and, you know, we just finished doing this whole EP.
Right, right.
And after it
all...
See
you later.
Pretty much.
So
we're
just
like, oh, well. Exactly.
I love it. I love it. That's what I assumed it was, but I didn't want to be like, so is it about that? Is it about the band members leaving?
Yeah.
That exciting thing.
It's pretty straightforward.
Yeah, but it happens. It happens. Especially like with brothers, you know, like you guys will be in the band.
Yeah.
And then you'll be as famous as Oasis was, is, and then eventually, like, you'll hate each other and then you won't speak to each other.
Yeah, I'm looking forward.
So, yeah, look forward.
I already hate him.
Look, great. You're one step ahead of Oasis. Or I guess they've hated each other for a really long time already.
Since birth.
Pretty much. But they did some good music. Do you guys like Oasis? Did you like Oasis?
Just Morning Glory.
Just Morning Glory?
Yeah.
Nothing on Definitely Maybe, the first one?
No.
I love that. Cigarettes and Alcohol? Like T-Rex ripoff? Oh.
I just like the big hits.
Just the big hits.
That's just me.
And soon you guys will be Just the Big Hits. That'll be your next band name. Just the Big Hits.
They're changing it again next week.
I came up with your next band name. Congratulations.
Awesome.
I accept cash. So yeah, this has been On Tour Now. Check out Like Adults, likeadults.com, and listen to that brand new, spanking new song right there.
A la EP.
Oh, so wait, how many songs is it?
Five songs.
Oh, it's five? I just thought it was one song.
No, it's five songs,
oh,
and
crap.
It's free.
It's free, and so is this what you just recorded after the whole thing happened?
No, this is what we were recording.
This is what you were working on?
Yeah, and instead of us, you know, charging or doing anything like that, we just want to give it out to people.
Cool. Well, that's fun. So check out So Much For That, and be sure to subscribe and all that good stuff so you can win free things. And I had you guys give advice before. What's one more bit of advice from each of you that we can end the show on?
Don't be a dick.
Don't be a dick. I like that one.
Dick.
That's a good one.
Check it out. Check out the EP, I guess. You know.
What does that have to do with
that? That's just like a good life goal. Like, if you're going to like do anything with your life,
just
make
check
sure
out
you
that.
Listen to that first.
Your life advice is very self-serving. I like it. Don't be a dick, but check out our EP.
Yeah, right.
Good stuff. All right. Thanks for tuning in, guys. We'll see you next week with another band. I think Litronics. Right, Scoot? Litronics is next week. Hey! That's a good way. Yeah, he can't talk because he's like...
he's a mime.
He's like Hector Salamanca or something over there. Alright, so we'll see you guys next week. Thanks for joining us.
Bye.